Myself Mohammed Tokay from class 12. I am standing before you to represent my seminar on topic variables and data types in JavaScript. Before going to my main topic, I want to introduce JavaScript. JavaScript is a dynamic computer programming language. It is lightweight and most commonly used as a part of web pages. It allows client-side script to interact with the user and make dynamic pages. It is an interrupted programming language with object-oriented capabilities. Now I will move to my main topic, which is variable. It is a container that store a value. This is a very similar to the containers that we use in our daily life to store rice, salt, water, etc. Here is one real life example of this. Here I have a container which containing sugar, and here is the level which indicates that it is sugar. Then this container, assume this container as a variable. And assume this sugar as a data or variable value. Then assume this level as a variable name. Now I will show this in the JavaScript code. Okay, here is the JavaScript code of variables. Here is the variable name, and here is the variable list in string. Here I will explain you clearly all about variables. Here var is the variable keyword, and a is the variable name, and value inside semicolon is the variable value or variable data. Now I will explain types of variable. There are mainly three types of variable. First one is var. It is a keyword that is used for declaring a variable in a JavaScript. It can be redeclared in a program. Then second one is const. The const is declaration creates an immutable reference to a value. The value of const cannot be changed or redeclared throughout the program. Then third one is let. The keyword let in JavaScript is used to declare a variable that is block scope in the JavaScript. Now, JavaScript data types. JavaScript data types are of two types. One is primitive, another one is non-primitive. In primitive, there are six divisibles. First one is string, second one is number, third one is boolean, fourth one is undefined, fifth one is null, and sixth one is symbol. And in non-primitive, there is only object. Here is the example of primitive data type. Here is the variable name, and here is the variable data. Here is a number. In variable data, I have a number that is 10. In the number, you can use any integer. And in string, you have to use double quotation to represent a string. In boolean, you have to use true or false. In null, null means empty or void. And in undefined, there is no value or the value you never defined. Now, here is the example of non-primitive data type. In non-primitive data type, there is object and another one is array. Array is mostly used nowadays for as a database purpose and all. That's all. Thank you and have a good day.